Welcome. You're watching a physics show video. We're going to show you a neat demonstration using infrared light. We have a heating element, like the one on an electric stove or in a toaster, in front of a special mirror. Now we'll swing around our equipment to show you a second mirror. In front of the second mirror is a bundle of matches, and we'll use heat in the form of light generated by the heating element in front of the first mirror to set the matches on fire. The first question you can ask is, how can light set something on fire? Don't you need heat? Well, if you step it out into the sunlight, you'll quickly remember that light does carry heat. The next thing we need to understand is the mirrors. They are in a special shape called a parabola. A feature of a parabola is that any line starting at a place called the focal point will be reflected straight outwards by the mirror. This is how flashlights work. In our case, the heat from the element is sent out in one direction. When the light hits the second mirror, all of this happens in reverse, and the heat is concentrated on the matches at the focal point. This is similar to using a magnifying glass to start a fire. Looking at the matches, we can see the red glow of the heating element reflected in the mirror behind it. But this is just a small circle of light. It turns out that most of the heat is invisible. It's called infrared light, and we'll talk about that in a minute. I can see smoke. If we wait a little longer, the matches will burst into flames. That was really neat. We were able to set those matches on fire using only reflected light. Now we're going to pull back the camera so you can see how far apart those mirrors were. We set the matches on fire from very far away. We need to talk more about infrared light. Sir William Herschel knew that sunlight could make you feel warm. He also knew that you could use a prism to divide light into the colors of the rainbow. He took a thermometer and placed it into each of the different colors, measuring the change in temperature compared to the thermometers far away from the light. He made an amazing discovery. The thermometer got warm in a band beyond red light. This meant there was a color our eyes could not see, and this invisible light still carried heat. He named this color infrared, which means below red, since it was just below red in the spectrum. But Herschel did more than just this. He, along with his sister Caroline, was a great astronomer. Today, most people know him as the person who discovered the planet Uranus, but many astronomers think that his discovery of infrared light is just as important as a planet. Astronomers like using infrared light because of its relationship with temperature. In the picture to the left, we see the constellation Orion in the visible spectrum. Rigel is in blue, which means it is hot. Betelgeuse is in red, which means that it is cooler. But both are stars, so they are very hot indeed. If we look at the same patch of sky in the infrared, we can see cooler objects. Many of these are clouds of dust and gas, where stars are just being born. They aren't hot enough to shine with the light our eyes can see. Witnessing the birth of stars is just one of the advantages of using infrared light in astronomy. Infrared astronomy has a big problem. Infrared light is blocked by our atmosphere. This picture tells the story. Our atmosphere lets through visible light and also radio and television, but infrared light can't get through. This is mainly due to water vapor in our atmosphere. If only there was a way to get above all of that water vapor. The Stratospheric Observatory for Infrared Astronomy, Sofia for short, is operated by NASA and the German Space Program. It is an infrared telescope with a 100-inch mirror mounted on a 747 airplane. When Sofia gets above the water in our atmosphere, a door opens at the back of the plane for the infrared telescope. Let's look at the insides of Sofia. The people running the telescope sit in front. The telescope is in back. The telescope's job is to collect infrared light, which is then sent to a scientific instrument. A key feature of Sofia is that these instruments can be taken out and replaced by other instruments if scientists want to look at different things in the infrared light. This is a flexibility we don't have with space-based telescopes and also allows for repairs and upgrades. Another advantage of an airplane is that it can fly to many different places. In 2013, Sofia was sent to New Zealand to observe constellations in the southern sky. These are best viewed from the southern hemisphere. Ground-based telescopes can't move like Sofia. Sofia is able to go to specific places to observe events like eclipses and comets that could not be seen from other locations. Sofia is an observatory with many unique abilities that will help advance our knowledge of our universe. We hope you've enjoyed learning about infrared light, astronomy, and the Sofia program. We will see you at the next physics show.